You've been sort of spending most of, what, 2002, making the second album?
Yeah, to our shame, it took us about 10 months.
You didn't think it was going to take that long?
No, yeah. No. I was reading the studio. We kept the studio diary on the webpage, and I was reading it there the other day, and there was an entry for July that was a triumphant, we finished kind of thing. But after then, we all went away for a couple of weeks and came back, and it just... I think we were all kind of tiptoeing around the idea for a while, but we did realise we needed to kind of record some more songs and remix.
Because, like, if you had finished it that long ago and then you did a short acoustic tour in December, did you feel the songs change when you actually did them in front of an audience?
Yeah, they did, yeah. And for some of them, definitely, I wish we had had that opportunity to actually play them to people for a while before actually recording them. But.
Because, like, after the first album, Now That Am I, you also, like, you played with Gemma Hayes,
yeah,
and somebody else played with Mundy and that. Do you, when you come back to the band, do you bring something different because of doing
those
things?
Especially with Gemma having made that record with Dave Friedman in New York, that was an amazing experience. And, you know, he's made some of my favourite records over the last 10 years, so
yeah.
it was great. And also with that, it's playing on other people's records, there's a wonderful kind of lightness about it. There's no responsibility, and
of course,
I kind of
yeah.
miss that now.
Right, yeah.
I follow you at a distance, bounce through others' eyes like a pinball machine. Dressed as Mr. Walker, but in disguise. I could have been a contender, but instead I'm content with the gin and tonic dressing gown I lament. One night only, the great and the glory. Let's see if it stuck. You still love me?
Responsibility of making this album anyway, you were prepared for the second one and you're ready to go with the release date, which is when?
April. It'll be early April. Man.
It'll be early April. Okay, so tell us then about this album, Music in Mouth. You started off in beautiful downtown something, Our Lady's Island in Wexford?
Yeah, yeah. We hired a house down there last Christmas for about 3 weeks and sat around and lit roaring fires and set up all the gear in the living room and wrote songs together. And that's kind of, it was quite a departure from how we'd written the first record, which was Dave or I bringing songs to the band, more or less complete, and kind of having them orchestrated. And this was a far more kind of, songs are written by the band in a much more kind of organic way, which was great. That was the best part of the whole process for me.
Okay, and that's the first bit. Then you go to Ridge Farm in Surrey.
Yeah,
and you get what, producers you really want or producers you were given?
No, there was a guy that we had met, an engineer named Jamie Cullum, and he'd recorded some of the demos with us, and we really got on well, and he kind of knew what we wanted out of the songs and how we wanted them to end up on tape. So, yeah, it was. We didn't really need or certainly want a kind of big name producer, you know. And I think that, you know, it being our first record for Ireland, they certainly didn't suggest any of that. They were really happy with the demos we'd made ourselves, so we kind of kept on that route.
And you're happy, I presume, with the second album, Paul?
Yeah, and I am. It's it has the last 6 months of making it were very frustrating because I much prefer to be able to just take photographs and move on. And, you know, it's been two and a half years since
yeah.
the first record came out when this
yeah.
comes out, and that's, you know...
It's long enough, yeah.
It is,
yeah,
it is
yeah.
you know.
OK, well, listen, we're going to play a piece of music from Bell X1. As a final question, are you a gambling man, Paul?
I can be, yeah.
Like, as in, I'll see your heart and I'll raise your mind.
Yes, yeah. Triple X Golden Maverick.
OK, we're not playing that track, though. We're playing this one here. Thanks a million, Paul. Bell X1.
Finish this jigsaw. I find the pieces behind the couch. I dream we were slow dancing. I dream I knew your name. Between sleep and waking, we're drinking flavor rock and bed. I wake, I'm all king's horses and all king's men. I make wildlife and rivers from swing above white water noise. No one can hear my screams.
That's music there from Bell X1.